Go ahead and get started. I will turn things over to Veer in a moment for talking about the viewer pipeline and anything of that sort that needs to be reviewed. I wanted to make a point of asking the third-party viewer community to, as actively as possible, help us with testing of the uplifted regions on Aditi. So Cloud Sandbox 1 through 4, and there are a couple of others, and Mastodox can give you pointers. If there are things you need done to the configuration of those regions or land ownership on Aditi uplifted regions, we can certainly, grab your favorite Linden and we'll try to sort out whatever you need. We are making very, very good progress on support for uplifted regions, and this testing is key to our confidence to bring that to Agni and to make those regions resident accessible. We've had some Linden-only regions on Agni uplifted for some time now. But it's there are plenty of regions on Aditi and they don't cost anything. Among other things, our ability to bring uplifted regions to Agni is a gating factor in our ability to reopen region sales. So it would be good for everybody if we could do that. It's all getting very exciting. It's getting very real, and we would appreciate any feedback that you can share with us about how well it's working in any respect. So please participate as actively as possible because you people understand how this is supposed to work, and you write better than average bug reports, which is a big deal. So thank you for whatever help you can spare us. Do we have a copy of Testlevania on Aditi Mastodox? Okay. Yeah, there you go. All right. As usual, he's one step ahead of me. Veer, I'll turn it over to you for the viewer pipeline discussion.
All right.
Sure.
Let's see. So we have a larger than usual collection of viewers that are pretty close to promotion at this point. I think the anticipated next promotion is going to be Mate. That's the maintenance release. It starts with a B, and I don't know how to pronounce it. But then we also.
Bottomless
Okay, thank you. If you drink the stuff, it's probably even harder to pronounce. Let's see. So that just came out like 10 minutes ago with an updated RC. So if all goes well with that, and we have enough hours against it, we'll be promoting that next week. There'll probably be a shorter than average wait to get the next one out after that, which is likely to be Mesh Uploader. That one is also in good shape right now. And then going for the threefer, we're hoping to get Love Me Render out, which is the EAP follow-on graphics issues. Getting very close. There's one kind of persistent issue with alphas and local edit mode that we've put a lot of time in on and haven't gotten to the bottom of yet. But there's a there should be an RC update coming soon that has fixes for the other bugs that we were done for that. So keep an eye out for that, and with a decent amount of luck, we'll be able to get three RCs out fairly soon. I surely hope. Obviously, Load Me Render is a long-time player at this point that we're really very much interested in getting out. Farther down the list, you know, we have a whole series of Mate viewers going at any given time, so there will be another one in the RC right away once Mate B goes out. But beyond that, we have a couple of project viewers that are probably less close to going out, and the viewer profile project is currently kind of blocked. It's depending on web work, and the web folks are very much tied up with Uplift-related work right now, so that one is probably not going to be going out in the future. So basically, we're looking at three RCs that should be going out soon, and it may get a little quiet after that. Try to get some other things just a little farther along. And that's it.
Yeah, to emphasize what Mastodoc said, the more test results we get from you folks, the more confidence we'll have of bringing them up on Agni. The other answer is that we haven't decided yet, but we're getting pretty close. We do have a list of must fixes, and we're working through them. And many of the items on that list were the result of somebody doing testing on a DD and reporting a problem. So in some sense, that testing has slowed things down. In another much more important sense, it has ensured that when we do get to Agni, we will have more problems. So we really appreciate the people.
Just to re-emphasize what Oz said, and probably disappoint Kitty in the process. Sorry, we don't even have any maintenance simulators in QA right now. It is all uplifted simulators all the time. That's what everyone's doing. So we're already putting 100%, and in some cases more than 100%, into this. So it is entirely dependent on how much additional test effort multiplication we can get from the community.
Yeah, we're not doing a lot of even bug fixing on the simulator at the moment. Only either ridiculously easy or ridiculously important things, and not much of the former. Unfortunately, we don't have much of the latter. So we're trying real hard to get everything working smoothly, uplifted. We're getting very, very close. But it's kind of all hands on deck for uplift these days.
Yeah, pretty happy we didn't break the Firestorm Bridge.
Yes, it's an immense relief.
Full disclosure, we do have another set of changes that should be transparent regarding HTTP. But if we're not careful, they might not be. So there's still a chance it could break. But.
Haha.
always the optimist.
Kitty, that is, however, a concerning bug. This doesn't mean we'll never get to it. It just means that it's not going to be immediate.
It's not going to be quite as quick as it might otherwise be.
I do have a rather extensive list of bugs that will be addressed on my backlog, Giddy. There are just some other things that are a little more critical for me to address.
The in-viewer login cookie issues may not require server-side changes, which means it's different people. So I'm not sure where that falls in the priority list at the moment, but we can review that and try to get it some attention.
Kitty, do you have a JIRA for the in-viewer login cookie thing? This cookie issue is currently flagged as a web issue, which, if that's right, it's going to have a tough time getting a time slice soon, I think. It's like it's been kicking around for a while.
Kitty, what do you mean it does that even in your normal browser? Like if you press the shop button and you're logged into the marketplace in your normal browser, it doesn't open as logged in? Oh, I see. Yeah. This is true. But if you logged into Marketplace, you wouldn't need to log in again. It stays logged in.
Huh. I just tried it and it worked for me. It did the, logged in to SecondLife.com in Chrome and then went to Marketplace.secondlife.com and I'm still logged in. This would be some sort of, I don't know, cookie acceptance setting or something.
Oh god.
I can repro the shop button. Repro.
Yeah, no, I agree. If you use the internal browser, like with the shop button, it doesn't seem to
It's a bad experience, is what
have you logged in. Yeah, that's a drag.
all agree.
I mean, we just did an update with the C++ version with what was the tools update viewer that got us up to VS 2017. Probably won't be doing another update that soon, just you know, because we just did it and there's a lot of other stuff going on. But you know, contributions that take advantage of stuff that's supported by the current versions are fine. Yeah, well, I mean, I don't know. At least with Microsoft, one tends to track the other. What specifically are you looking for in C++?
the reflections we let me render. Yeah, the camera roll, yes. Turns out it was just a matrix. It had to be updated properly. Don't show that picture to Steel.
Thanks, everyone.